Lake Carmi residents are hoping a new aeration system will put an end to the toxic algae blooms they dealt with for years.
From everything we've read, this is a scientifically proven means to stop the legacy phosphorus from fueling algae blooms. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that.
A Michigan-based contractor has spent the past few weeks installing a customized system for Vermont's fourth largest lake.
We like simple, so we've tried to design these systems down to the key components that make the aeration system work.
The first component is a compressor. It pumps air through a metal hose that runs underground to a manifold near the shore. Here, the air is channeled into 40 different hoses that each run along the bottom of the lake to a diffuser. John's team has laid about 45 miles of hose under the lake, roughly the distance from Lake Carmi to Burlington. The diffusers are made of a porous ceramic material that distributes the air into the water. The goal isn't actually to pump oxygen into the bottom of the lake, it's to mix up the lake water from the bottom to the top.
What it really does is drag the water at the bottom of the lake up to the surface and get it exposed to the atmosphere where there's plenty of oxygen. This is really a circulatory system for a lake.
Phosphorus pollution has led to algal blooms on Lake Carmi for decades.
When I was a kid, every August, we'd end up with green water. So, you know, this has been going on. It's not something that's brand new, but it's been getting progressively worse.
But then we had another significant bloom in 2015. And one of our Lake Carmi campers filmed a camper's faucet where they turned the faucet on. They were drawing water from the lake, and it was green.
This is the water coming out of the sink in the bathroom. October 6, 2015.
I got an eye infection in both eyes during a bloom. You know, the wind was coming right off the lake, and we're right there.
Some of the worst blooms formed in 2017.
I mean, some of them were stunning. I mean, it looked like a mosaic when you look down at the algae. It has patterns and colors, swirls. You know, I mean, if you looked at it and you took a piece of it and you put it on a canvas, you'd say, oh, wow. But, you know, in the water, it's just horrible. And it smells. It's not a nice smell.
Yeah.
It's not a nice smell.
Yeah.
2017, I got two high infections again. This time the doctor said, I think it's your problem at the lake.
Because of the impact of the 2017 blooms and how significantly bad they were, that's what generated the attention and I think finally the motivation that, hey, we have to do something for Lake Carmi.
In 2018, the legislature passed a bill that declared Lake Carmi a lake in crisis, which led to an accelerated water cleanup plan, including an aeration system.
Aeration is the right move for this lake because if we can keep oxygen down at the bottom all the time through the summer, it prevents that chemical release from happening. No phosphorus, no algae.
Locals hope this won't just heal the lake. It'll heal the relationships between residents, farmers, and state officials that have been strained over the years.
That type of relationship and that type of communication wasn't there before.
Yeah.
So we're working on that. That's a work in progress.
Yeah.
That's a work in progress.
I think that this installation this week is making for a whole new attitude here at the lake and in the town of Franklin and in the state of Vermont. A more positive attitude that, you know, something can be done for water quality and we're doing it.